From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Portland residents get two extra days to dig out from this one. City officials say because of all the snow piling up, the added time should help people clear their sidewalks. Still, people were removing snow today, including firefighters who had to dig out more than 1,600 fire hydrants across the city. Cleanup efforts started early, even before the city lifted its parking ban at 6 a.m.
I had a 4-foot-high wall this morning in my driveway when I got out of it. So I got up at 4 in the morning and started chopping ice just so we could get out of the house.
For the third time in the history of the city's recycling program, Wednesday's service was canceled. It's rescheduled for Saturday for those residents. And the city of Biddeford has actually issued a snow load advisory to all property owners following yesterday's storm. Biddeford officials say they are concerned that many buildings and homes may have a big accumulation of snow on their roofs, which can lead to leaks, roof damage, and even collapse. By issuing the advisory, city officials say property owners needed to monitor how much snow is collected on their roofs and act quickly to remove it. A good deed turned into a big headache for a man whose GMC plow truck ended up crashing through the ice on Sebago Lake in Raymond last night. The truck's driver says he was trying to help out by plowing a path on the lake for two ice fishermen so they could reach their shack, and that is when he hit a soft spot on the ice. The truck with a sander attached crashed through about 1,500 feet, from the shore.
Well, there was a couple guys stuck on the ice, and I came out to see if they were okay. Plowed by them. I said, where are you guys going? They said, they're at that green ice shack right there. I said, well, I'll just plow you a path around it and go back out. Got all the way around it, started heading back out, and must have hit a thin spot because the back went underneath, and I bailed out of the truck, and here we are today.
Divers were on the scene this morning trying to get the truck free from the ice. The driver of the truck was not hurt and was able to get himself out of 6 feet of water. The truck is submerged in. He got out safely. Well, a judge in Cumberland County is expected to come back with a verdict tomorrow morning in the case of a Portland man accused of killing his girlfriend. A judge has had the case for 2 weeks now. Chad Gurney is on trial for killing his girlfriend Zoe Sarnacki back in May of 2009. Defense claimed that Gurney was delusional and not criminally responsible by reason of insanity. While the prosecution admits Gurney did have problems, it argues that he knew fully what he was doing and was not suffering from a major mental illness. A former youth pastor from Auburn pleaded not guilty to 6 sex charges against him. 22-year-old Joshua Williams in court this morning in Androscoggin County. He is accused of engaging in sex with a young male member of the First Assembly of God Church in Lewiston. The grand jury indicted him on 3 counts of gross sexual assault and 3 counts of unlawful sexual contact. A judge ordered Williams to not have contact with the alleged victim or anyone under the age of 16. And thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.